And this time, not all statements are correct, but the strongest one of them is. So, if you show just one single NP complete problem requiring exponential time to be solved, then all NP complete problems will require exponential time to solve. And the reason for that is that all NP complete problems are connected to each other using polynomial time reductions. So if one of them requires exponential time and another one requires polynomial time, then that just cannot be, because say if this problem here requires polynomial time, then that would mean that you can solve SAT, for example, in polynomial time, which would then mean that you can solve this problem over here in polynomial time, and so on and so on. All problems that are NP complete are, from a viewpoint of polynomial or exponential time, equally hard to solve. Which would also mean that the weaker statement here is true. Some problems in NP are only solvable in exponential time. Yes, if all NP complete problems require exponential time, then there are problems in NP which require exponential time. Finally, the statement down here, that is not true. All problems in NP are only solvable in exponential time. That is not true. Not all problems in NP require exponential time. So remember our picture from before where we said that P is basically a subset of NP. So these problems here will still be solvable in polynomial time. It doesn't matter if there are some problems in here that require exponential time. It doesn't affect these problems here in P.